Hello. I was in the middle of doing my makeup and I was like, shit, I gotta go live because I was gonna play music for you. Does this scare some of you? Because it scares me. I'm scared I'm gonna pull my eyelashes right out and cut them. The EP is coming out Friday, but technically it's like Thursday at midnight, but it would still be Friday. But you just gotta stay up a little bit. I'm gonna show you guys a trick, actually. Boys and girls, please pay attention. This is cream blush. It's Hibiscus by Beauty Counter. Okay, so I take a little bit of this blush and I put it right here. So it like gives you like a sun-kissed look. You smile and you go, and you just kind of give yourself a sun-kissed look. You see that? It's subtle. It's subtle, but it gives you a little thing, a little, you know what I'm saying? Boy shit. Cilantro Rose, I think you should be quiet for a second because I think boys can do whatever they want. I think they can wear makeup if they want to, and you can wear makeup if you want to. Okay? The real thing that I wanted to do when I came onto this live was play you some music and talk about my music for a little bit. And also choose a little setting. I got balls. I got balls. I got these two balls from Target, or no, maybe it was Walmart. Ooh, this is an album cover right here. Look at this. I gotta pose. I gotta be like, Okay, we'll do that. Play that funky music, white boy. Anthony Ramos! You guys, I love Anthony Ramos. I am like probably one of your biggest fans, and so are probably like many teenage girls, but Anthony Ramos has a great album out called The Good and the Bad. Go listen to it. I'm gonna pull up. Okay, here I got the masters. Masters is like the final version of the songs that I have for the EP. EP. Okay, I'm gonna play Apocalypse, which is actually, I don't want to be, you know, I'm not supposed to say this, but it's actually my favorite track. It's my favorite track. I can say whatever I want, okay? It's my favorite track, and it better be your favorite too. I'm gonna try not to play the whole song. I didn't actually select what I wanted to play for you, so I'm gonna like skip around a little bit and explain what the song is about. So here, let's go. Let's play this. Okay, this is actually the second verse. I don't know what I'm doing. But listen to the beginning of this. My friend Sean, who's teaching me piano, did this little guitar that I absolutely love. I'm gonna stop. I'm ruining it. So that is like that line right there is like a little metaphor. I was basically the overall picture of this is I was in a relationship that was really toxic, and I didn't know that it was toxic at the time. Obviously, you don't really know when you're in it. You can't really see what's around you. So that was like kind of we started dancing together, and all of a sudden everything started to fall apart around us, but I didn't really know. Oh my God, I'm about to play the whole song for you. Let me just stop for a second. This is
the Apocalypse.
I might be ruining the song. Who cares? Okay, I'm stopping. I have to stop myself. My label's gonna freak out. Okay. Okay, the next song is Todo Está Bien. This song is completamente en español, pero me hace sentir super super like relajada sin querer. Like, imagínate, estás en un carro with the windows down, the wind in your hair, in your armpits. You're like, Okay, this is this song. That kind of makes me, this makes me feel that way. Todo está bien aquí. Oh, I did this. I actually wrote this in Miami. I was in a really good state of mind at this point. I was, and now I'm not. I was in the studio with Gio. GOKB is his Instagram. He actually produced this one. And pretty much Elena, too. Elena is a writer. She was in the room, and it was just the three of us. And I started like coming up with this melody. I did the piano because I was like, let's do a song kind of Jhené co-inspired, super chill. Todas las vibras, all the like chill energy. And he was like, okay, let's do that. And so I started playing the piano. I got the this little thing right here. Boom, boom. It's really simple. Boom, boom. Okay, I'm not playing that part, yeah. This is my story of my life. Si lo nuestro ya pasado, engañarme no tiene sentido. Pensaste que iba a doler. Yo sé muy bien que esta vez se terminó. Se es uno. Okay, I'm playing the whole goddamn song. I gotta stop myself. This is like a listening party, actually. I don't know what I'm doing. okay, so the next song, we're skipping to our feelings. I'm in my feels. I was like enamorada back in 2000. What am I kidding? I fall in love like every 3 months. I fall in love like every day. I fall in love with new people every day. And I just, you know, I am a loving person. A lot of people say, oh, you're flirtatious or whatever. But I'm not, I don't know. I kind of just, it's just the way that I am. And I can't help it. And this song is called Loving Kind. And it's kind of about a specific person. But so it's a very complicated situation. And they probably have no idea it's about them. Like, I'm the type of person who is very talkative to people I, like, have no interest in. And then they're like, oh, you like me. I'm like, nah. But when it comes to people I'm actually interested in, I can't say I get really shy. I start, like, I look like a deer in the headlights when they talk to me. It's ridículo. Like, me siento súper, just embarrassed. Oh, my perrita está afuera. She's waiting for me to let her in. Should I let her in? This is Rue, by the way. I got her yesterday. We're just fostering her, but she's... Let me see if I can pick her up. She's the homie. Honestly, I love her.
Come here, bud. Okay, I lift you up. I put you on this chair.
This is Rue. She's actually not that big. She looks pretty big, but she's not that big. I'm so sorry. I'm gonna put you down now. I'm sorry for torturing you. I love love. Okay, so this is Loving Kind, and it's kind of tender. It's like getting our feelings. What's like a good color for this moment? Let me put this here. I like this color. I like this color. Okay. I'm so excited to play this video. Okay. That was my favorite melody in this whole song, so that's all I'm gonna play. Just kidding. I'll play you the rest, but she wants to leave, so I'm gonna... Here, go, be free! Play. I'm gonna answer questions after, but y'all gotta just listen with me. This is Don't Waste My Time, ready? Desire, how I feel when all she cold. Pushing you away, open your pun and me close. Drop this out of him, I will say you let me know. Tell me if you want it, yeah, yeah, yeah. Cause if I'm being honest, yeah, yeah, yeah. I don't wanna waste my time. If you're not the loving kind, don't waste my time.
Tell me if you want it, yeah, yeah, yeah. Cause if I'm being honest, yeah.
I'm not even gonna sing anymore. This is my career now. Just balancing the shit on my head. Look at how good I am. Watch. I'm a little shimmy shimmy. Okay, what the f am I doing? We are not gonna be in our fields anymore, okay? I'm calling it. We are gonna move on to chocolate. Chocolate is basically like it's the ass thrower. I feel like every album, every EP needs an ass thrower. Like where you just kind of just dance to it and you can, you know, you can be in the club. But the song itself, this song is mostly about smell taste association. So when I'm like all about smells, I'm all about like when I hug you, I'm going to smell you. And if you smell good, I'm going to tell you, you smell good. This one person reminds me of chocolate. Sorry, got a little carried away there. Chocolate. This part, the beginning is my favorite part. Or is it? It's just the piano. There you go. I remember now. Softest words like raindrops on cement. Swear that I can recognize this in a past life. Yeah, savor every second that I get. So, the lyric, softest words like raindrops on cement at the beginning. I love the sound and the smell and just everything about raindrops on cement. I think it's amazing. And it reminds me of nostalgia summer when I was a kid. It's great. So that's why I put that there. As we will do this all again. Oh my god, I'm playing the whole song again. God damn it. Why am I doing this? Okay. I'm gonna move on to the last song now so that I can answer your questions or your disses or your compliments, whatever you choose to do. This is called The Chase. What's up? How you doing? I feel the rush now. Been so bad. Oh, I gotta tell you what this is about. So The Chase is about, y'all ever heard the song? I don't know if you heard the song, but if there are any Peruanos in this live stream, hay una canción. Hablan del toro, el toro mata. The song's like over 100 years old. Oh my god, I got eyelash in my eye. Holy shit. Wait. I hate this so much. It's gonna be in there for like 10 minutes. I'm actually gonna start twitching for the rest of the video. Okay, there you go. Anyways, toro mata. It's like over 100 years old. So now I can, you know, it's like public domain. So now I can use it. And we remixed it into this kind of like trappy beat where I'm like singing in a high-pitched tone over it. It's about the chase. If you've ever seen or heard of, I don't know, not toreos. It's just bullfighting, really. It's a bullfighting, the guy's holding the flag and then the bull. I mean, usually they kill a bull, which I don't like. I don't think you should be killing animals for entertainment. But it's like part of the culture, you know, it was a really big deal. It was a really, really big deal. Like, these bullfighters were celebrities back in the day. And, I mean, nowadays it's not so big. But, especially in Spain, Mexico, Peru. But, yeah, this is about the chase, the pursuit of somebody else. And I'll explain to you after. You got my interest. Now hit what this was. I wanna know. So the lyrics here are the priest, stay on red till you double text. Yeah, the game just feels so good. Because, you know, sometimes when we're initially talking to somebody will like leave them on red on purpose, which, you know, I'm not about the games anymore, but like sometimes you kind of have to nowadays because people have such short attention spans and people follow all kinds of beautiful girls on Instagram. So in order to like be different from the rest, you can't be just so available. So basically, you know, you stay on red to your double text and it's the game. And I'm guilty of playing it, yes, but so are all of you. Is it the light in this place? Or is it the look on your face? Am I in love with you or am I in love with the chase? Okay? And then it's, or am I in love with the drama that brings me back? Only want what I can't have. Is it the look on your face? Is it the light in this place? Am I in love with you or am I in love with the chase? And right now, once I get out of quarantine, I don't know what's gonna happen. I don't know. I feel like my standards are gonna be so low. I'm gonna be like at the grocery store, someone's gonna look at me once and I'm gonna be like, am I in love? Stupid. Dumb. Anyways, yeah, that is just a little taste of my EP. I'm so excited for it to come out. I'm gonna do a lot of like more fun interactive things for you because I'm just really excited and I'm kind of not really doing anything else. So I appreciate the love. I'm seeing a lot of emojis that aren't like sad ones or mad ones. So I'm feeling pretty good. Me encanta como tú lo juegas. Me regresas y luego me dejas. Me subes y me bajas. Esta vez tú no te escapas. No, no. Me muero de ganas. Yo voy por donde tú vayas. Yeah, yeah. Okay.